the picture, all the bacteria are the same.
Here's this super complex, amazing system called life.
Bacteria produce a pigment.
Now, you can harness its power if you know what's going on behind the scenes.
2309, it's this class called Bioinstrumentation and Measurements for Biological Systems.
It directly connects mental models of complicated things to getting to some kind of performance in the real world.
It's one of the mandatory lab classes for course 20, which is bioengineering.
Bioengineering is such an interesting field, and I think that it's only going to get more and more comprehensive to study more things, world issues that we can solve.
Then you really can't do that without microscopes and without these different ways to see what's going on.
I'm Maxine Jonas. I'm a teaching faculty in the Department of Biological Engineering at MIT.
Steve Wasserman, an instructor in the Department of Biological Engineering.
Jenny Gao, a rising senior in course 20, also minoring in Applied International Studies.
Michael Mandanis, a rising senior in course 20. I'm actually minoring in computer science.
Kevin Soon Lee, studying biological engineering, but because of this class, I'm also looking forward to adding electrical engineering as my second major.
Karana Groff, a junior in the biological engineering department. I myself don't always work with things like resistors, capacitors, and more technical components. So I was really excited to learn how to use everything.
We draw a lot of comparisons and parallels between electrical engineering or mechanical engineering to the world of biological engineering. So a signal that used to be a voltage for an electrical engineer, for instance, is now a salinity of the medium in which yeast cells grow.
The very hands-on, students build microscopes and microfluidic devices, and we teach a lot of concepts about modeling and measurement, and then we apply them in the lab.
I don't know if it's the fact I'm working with the microscope or if it's because Steve and Maxine, and also there's a whole host of people who made being here really special, and that's why I kept returning semester after semester, and I began TAing in spring of 2020, so right when the pandemic started.
I was hoping to get this class after the whole COVID thing passed, we could get in person, but I think the virtual class was just as good, if not better.
How do you take a class about building microscopes online?
And so they sent us these plastic boxes, they called them nerd kits.
Make your own mini microscope at home.
Every week we'd have a problem set with a new thing to do with all of these pieces.
It had a lot of the online lessons and video setups.
We had a Slack channel. You could message out just sort of like into the general chat where like other students might be able to answer your question, or like TAs or professors.
Help, I'm so confused. And Maxine would be on Zoom with me in the next 5 minutes. It's really absurd how nice they made everything for us.
I know how lucky we are here. We have the resources to do what we want. We have students that come in and love the subject and are interested in it, which is even more amazing.
There's really a bond beyond the mentor-mentee, usually just a human being bond that gets made in laboratory classes.
When your goal is to make a student care about something, not only do they have to deeply understand it, but they also have an emotional connection with what they do. And this permeates into how we treat one another, and I think that really shows in the 2309 community.
We're looking forward to integrating all of the great new things that we developed for COVID. And we're still looking for the ideal tool for a class that has a significant online component and a significant personal interaction component.
1.5 times more sophomores declared biological engineering as their major at MIT compared to previous years. So it may be that there's now a thirst for biological engineering and that people see the 21st century as being the century for life sciences.